Hi, this is Comp 1010 at the University of Manitoba. I'm Dr. Celine LaTulip, and today I'm going to be talking to you about functions and the side effects that can happen in processing. So there's a lot of good reasons to use functions. They improve the readability of your program. As long as you make a bunch of functions that each do one small specific job and you give them good names, it really helps to make your program more understandable. Functions need to be well-defined, and what that means is you need to know what it does, and it should only do one small thing, what the parameters are, so what data needs to be passed in, and what the result is, so what happens on screen and what might be returned as data. So you really want to comment all of this at the start of functions. And so over here we have the pumpkin function that I created that draws pumpkins. And so a good comment at the top of this would say, this draws a pumpkin at specified location as a specified size. And then it identifies what's needed, the data that's passed in, need X and Y to specify where to draw the pumpkin, diam for how big to make the pumpkin, and it specifies that there's no return value here. So by doing all of this, it keeps your code local and reasonably small and a lot easier to manage. So functions also allow you to reuse common code in many different places. So if you recall the example of this function, I was able to put a call to function inside of a for loop inside of draw, and it caused pumpkins to be drawn all over the place. But the code for drawing each pumpkin was never repeated. It was just in the program once. So you never want to write the same code twice if you can avoid it. When you've got identical lines of code one after another, or nearly identical lines of code one after another, you probably want to put those into a loop. And when you've got sections of code, chunks of code that you've got multiple times in your program that are identical, then you probably want to put those into a function and just call that function once. So the job needs to be done in several places. Write it once, put it in a function, and call that function. This makes your code a lot more reliable. If you realize that there's a little bit of a bug in that or it needs to be altered slightly, you only have to change it in one place and then everything will work. So the next thing I want to talk to you about is this idea of side effects. When one function makes a change to a global variable and then some other function reads that global variable, it might not get what it was expecting. So processing actually stores a bunch of stuff as global state variables, such as the current fill color. So when you make a call to fill in one function, it actually has that effect everywhere else in the program until somewhere else in the program makes a call to fill. And that, sometimes that can be kind of unexpected. So that's a really good example of a side effect. So you really want to be very careful about using global variables and actually changing them from inside of a function. It's very hard to keep track of, and this doesn't scale well when you've got really large programs. So what should actually happen with a function is it should accept specific data that is needed, and then it should return data that needs to be changed. And using that should be done through the return mechanism. So if your function is going to change global variables, you need to be really, really careful and make sure that all of your other code understands that that change could happen. So let's look at a specific example. Say we have this function called addTax. It takes in a price that's a double, and then it calculates the price with the tax rate and returns it as a double. So specific data is coming in, and this is the preferred way for the data to come back so that it can be captured somewhere and maybe printed out or put into a database or what have you. So what I want you to think about here is, what if instead of doing what's depicted here, what if instead the addTax function changed a global price variable? In that case, the problem is we would never know whether price, that global price variable, actually was the price before the tax was added or after the tax was added. So by doing this, you could have a global price variable which you pass in, or a local price variable which you pass in, and then the return value can be saved in a price plus tax variable. And that way we can keep these separate and we know what's going on. So again, don't modify global variables unless you really have to. When you're writing functions, what you want to do is have what we call tunnel vision. So forget what the rest of the program is doing and focus on the simple problem in front of you. Take data in that's needed, do whatever you need to do, calculate or draw based on that data, and then pass back any data that the program needs that could be changed by what you've done. And that way you keep things controlled and you avoid these side effects. So if you have a price and you need to return a double that equals the price plus tax, how do you do that? Well, you don't worry about the rest of the program. You just write that one little function. And one last reminder that function parameters are copied. So when you call a function, the values that are passed in are copies of that data that you got out of variables or that was calculated. And so those changes to those local variables don't affect the rest of the program. The way you want to affect the rest of the program is by passing back data through the return mechanism. So let's go through an example of this. Say we have our draw function, and in here we have a local variable called double, or called lunch. It's a double and it stores 5. When we print out this, we're going to call this add tax function. It's going to call this. We're going to do this calculation. We're going to return it. So this is going to get replaced with that whole value, and it's going to output 5.6 to the console. But if we then print out lunch to the console, it's still going to print out 5 because this value of this local variable did not get changed. A copy of it was passed in to add tax, but it was just a copy, and so this variable is still the same. So the output here is 5. So again, really important to remember that when you pass data in to functions, you're passing in copies of that data. All right. So we often talk about what we call standalone functions, and those are functions that don't change globals. So functions that change globals take data from globals and can modify those globals, and that's not specified through the return mechanism. So when someone runs it, it can have these side effects, and that makes functions hard to use because you have to keep track of what all the impacts might be on those global variables changing throughout the rest of your program. So you can do this, but you really only want to do this when you have to break big code into smaller chunks. But then you've still got to really be careful to keep track of how all this stuff works together. Standalone functions, which is what we would prefer to write whenever we can, all the data comes in through parameters, the data goes out through the return mechanism, and we may look at globals to read constant values that are needed, but we're not going to make any changes to global variables. So this is what we want to aim for whenever we possibly can. It makes functions much easier to use. You don't have to worry about side effects. You don't have to worry that anything that you change might change something for somebody else who's writing other functions. Okay, so that's it. Thanks for watching.